it's a great pleasure and privilege to be here among, with you, Joe, amongst friends and admirers of Melinda. I'm really pleased that I'm able to be here. I'm a fellow of Melinda's College, Lady Margaret, or just LMH as it's known to everybody. And I was actually a contemporary of Melinda's at Oxford. And sadly, I never met her then. But I did meet her about 8 years ago when I returned to Oxford to work for LMH as their Director of Alumni Relations and Development. And I first actually physically met Melinda here in New York at the apartment when she was hosting a reception for all the alumni that we have here in New York City and around, which she habitually did in a way that was different to what the other colleges do. It was Melinda's apartment. It wasn't just sort of drinks and kind of stuffy things at the Harvard Club, if I don't want to offend anybody. But that's what all sort of colleges, my colleagues in other colleges have probably been doing this weekend, as a lot of us here from Oxford. But no, it was something different and special. The warmth of the family welcome in the apartment was something that people wanted to come to because it's something much more special. And I just remember that first occasion that I met you and Melinda here, and it's always stayed with me and with our other colleagues from Oxford. Actually, I remember, I think it was the first or second occasion I was there, I was being a bit kind of organized and had a kind of PowerPoint presentation to project somewhere in your apartment, and I failed totally to do it, but young Robert came and sold
technology engineer.
He got me out of a lot of trouble, and he worked really hard, and I'm very grateful to you to this day, Robert. Melinda was full of ideas, as you know, but she was full of ideas for helping LMH, and I was often on the phone to her, and she was very determined to sort of push ideas to me that couldn't accommodate perhaps all of them, but many of them I did and was pleased to do so. And we did a lot of things that Melinda suggested that delighted our alumni, and they were very pleased with. One of the things I remember most fondly was when she brought across and mounted a special edition of the Luminous Bodies exhibition at the Gerwood Gallery in LMH. That was a really special occasion with presentations by Francis Lannan and Robin Hammond, who's the curator of Blake and Turner at the Tate Gallery. The word you used the word about courageous when you were speaking about Carmen. And I just, if I have one little thing I can quote, that Robin Hamlin said that her work, he was comparing Melinda's work with that of Blake. Her work, like Blake's, exemplified the fearlessness that is part of the essence of great art. And she was. She was fearless in pushing the boundaries. So, Lady Margaret Hall, although we're a very small college, has spawned, I'm delighted to say, a whole range of people through its 120 years of history who have been very talented in the arts and writers. If I just note one or two of them, there's Marina Warner, the artist and critic, Fiona McCarthy, the biographer of Byron, and many others, Carol Churchill, noted playwright, Antonia Fraser, the historian, and more recently, and just down the road from here, I was chatting to her earlier today, Amanda Foreman, whose Georgiana, Duchess of Devonshire, now a film, was actually her PhD thesis at LMH when she was here. So Melinda is part of this rich tradition of artists that we have at LMH. So what I simply want to say is she brought great distinction to the college. We're very proud of her, both on the college and personally. But the energy and all the joy, really, is what I remember, with which she supported us. Thank you.